Let's check if new macOSs slow your Mac down. And especially when you install unsupported macOSs on your old Mac with OpenCore, if that slows it down even further or nothing at all. So how are we gonna do the benching? I have 3 devices, and it would have been 4 if my wife would have allowed me to use her iMac, but she didn't. My Mac Pro 5.1 from 2012, the MacBook Air from 2013, and the Mac Mini from 2014. And what we're gonna do, we install macOS Yosemite on all 3 devices, because that is the oldest that we can install on all 3 of them. And then we do some benchmarks. Boot time, space on the hard disk that the OS needs, Cinebench and Geekbench. And after that, we increase the macOS more and more to macOS High Sierra, that was the latest, which didn't require a metal graphics card. Then we're gonna use macOS Mojave, that's the first one which required a metal graphics card and is the latest official supported one for the Mac Pro after I changed the graphics card. Then we're gonna install Big Sur, the latest official on this device. Then we're gonna install Monterey, which is the latest official for the Mac Mini. And on the MacBook Air and the Mac Pro, we will obviously use OpenCore to install the newer macOSs. During the benchmark of my Mac Pro with the latest macOS Monterey and obviously OpenCore because it's not supported, the graphics benchmark of the Geekbench, the GPU benchmark, only showed about 2/3 of the performance than with Big Sur and before. The RX 580 is around 87,000, maybe 90,000 points. I let it rerun a few times to make sure. Whereas with Big Sur, it showed around 130,000 points. So we really have to dig down, what's the reason for that? Is it macOS Monterey? Is it the open core configuration, or maybe anything else? One more detail to the MacBook Air. This one has an active fan for cooling. The newer MacBook Airs have a problem with throttling with the M1 or M2 chips because they are fanless. They just have the case for heat dissipation. This one here is actively cooled by a fan, and so we don't expect any throttling of the CPU or integrated graphic unit for the benchmarks. And the benchmarks will also reveal one more thing. Those two Macs have nearly the exact same processor. It's an Intel 4th generation Haswell 4550U or 4560U. Both have 4 GB of RAM. This one is from mid 13, this one is from end 14. And so when we do the benchmarks, we can compare the performance decrease, if there is any, between a Mac Mini and a MacBook Air. So let's start with the MacBook Air from 2013 and with the macOS 10.10 Yosemite. This one only took 14 seconds from switching it on until you could log in for boot. With macOS High Sierra, this one increased to 17 seconds. With macOS Mojave, it was already 26 seconds. Big Sur took 34 seconds and Monterey 40 seconds. And that is, in my opinion, the most important thing here. It feels slow and it feels old because it needs so much time for booting up. But you will see later on in the benchmarks, there is nearly no difference between the different macOSs in the performance, in the sheer performance. So it's just a psychological thing that you think that that thing is old and slow because it takes whatever long for booting. For the disk space, it started with around 11 gigabytes for Yosemite and increases all the way up to 21 gigabytes for macOS Monterey. But that is quite a normal behavior, that new software needs more space. If you look at the performance chart here, blue is single core and green is multi-core. The MacBook Air, same with the Mac Mini, has a 2-core, 4 threads, but these are only 2 real cores. So that is the reason why the points just double from single core to dual core. Single core is all around 3000 points, but with macOS Monterey 12.6, this one decreases to 2200 points. that are 800 points less. That is nearly one third less performance. Multicore 5,400 points all the way until Monterey 12.5, and then with 12.6 it decreased to 5,000 points. That is 10% less CPU performance in 12.6. And honestly, I don't know what is causing that. I have to dig deeper into this, and maybe we see with the other Macs some behavior that is similar to that. Let's check the GPU performance. And the OpenCL benchmark with the Geekbench 4, Yosemite is quite slow with 15,500 points, but I think the drivers of the integrated graphics unit were not that polished, and then it constantly has 16,800 points. No difference here to macOS Monterey 12.5 or 12.6. So it seems it's only a sheer CPU problem. Let's look at the Cinebench. Just for information, the blue numbers, you have to take them times 10, because I divided them by 10 to make them fit in the picture here. It remains up until 12.5, and with 12.6 it's only 214. Same here, a noticeable decrease in performance. The OpenGL frame rate is all around 19 to 20 and a half frames, and that remains, and 19.2 with 12.6 is quite in the normal range. So same picture here, the MacBook Air loses a little bit of CPU performance with 12.6, but not graphic performance. Let's talk about the Mac Mini 2014, nearly the same hardware than the MacBook Air 13, same behavior. The amount of disk space you need for every new macOS increases, obviously, but there is a big difference between macOS Mojave and macOS Big Sur in the boot time. It increases from 21 to 39 seconds. That's nearly twice the time to wait until you can log in. When we talk about the Geekbench CPU scores, they're all around the same values. A slight decrease in macOS Mojave and Big Sur, and then it comes up again on macOS Monterey. But with Monterey 12.6, it loses nearly 500 points in the multi-core rating. Same behavior as the MacBook Air. And we will come to the comparison of those both Macs in a few moments. The Geekbench graphic benchmark, the OpenCL benchmark, all numbers don't change much. So there is no drop here. It seems to be a CPU drop in 12.6. Strange behavior though with Cinebench, because the performance drop is not found here in the Cinebench. With 12.6 and 12.5, there's nearly no difference in the benchmarks. So we definitely have to look more into that issue. So let's compare these two Macs. Nearly the same CPU, both have 4 GB of RAM and the integrated Intel HD graphics unit. When we compare the boot times, you see they're quite the same, but with the MacBook Air, it's more like a linear increase, and the Mac Mini has a very sharp increase to macOS Big Sur. By the way, I updated this Mac Mini with an SSD to have it more comparable, because the MacBook Air also has flash storage. With the Geekbench CPU performance, you see the drop in the single core performance of the MacBook Air, which doesn't happen on the Mac Mini. And with the multi-core performance of Geekbench, you see here both Macs lose around 500 points with 12.6. So it definitely slows your Macs down. The Geekbench graphic benchmark doesn't even show a difference, and so it seems to be a CPU related problem and not with the integrated graphics unit. And the Cinebench CPU and GPU benchmarks don't show any distinguishable difference between those two Macs. Let's check out what the Mac Pros has. Now let's talk about the Mac Pro from 2012. And here there is a whole different story with the boot times. It starts already with 34 seconds with Yosemite, increases to 46 or 40 seconds with High Sierra and Mojave, and then it needs around 52-53 seconds for Big Sur or Monterey. Same here, if it increases from like half a minute to nearly 1 minute boot time, it feels old and slow, and maybe you're thinking I get a new one. And the same with the hard disk space, this one increases from around 10 to 20 gigabytes. Okay, no problem for the Mac Pro, you can just install bigger hard disks. The Geekbench CPU score is a whole different story than with the MacBook Air or the Mac Mini. In this Mac Pro are two CPUs with 6 cores each, so these are 12 real cores. And so the single core performance is quite comparable, around 3000 points, and that doesn't change in 12.6. And the multi-core performance is 24 or 27,000 points because of the 12 core power of the Xeon processors. Why is there an increase from High Sierra to Mojave? I will explain that in the next picture, because I changed the graphics card from the Radeon HD 5770 non-metal graphics card to a Radeon RX 580. And even though this is a CPU benchmark, it seems that it has some influence on the benchmark score. But now let's look at the graphic performance, and then you see Yosemite and High Sierra 10,500 points. That is the old graphics card. Then I exchanged the graphics card and did the benchmark again in High Sierra, and this one jumped up to 136,000 points. And then it took the performance around 131,000 points, and then comes Monterey. It loses 1/3 of its performance and only hits 94,000 points. Doesn't matter which Monterey version I used. I did the benchmark with 12.5, 12.6, then I did it with the first version, 12.0, all around 90,000 points. Then I redid the benchmark for Big Sur, 11.6.8, 131,000 points. What happens here? So the MacBook Air loses CPU power with 12.6. The Mac Pro loses graphic performance. And just for completion, the Cinebench though, and by the way, the Cinebench points in blue, you have to take times 100 because they didn't fit into that picture here, are all around 1600. No real decrease in 12.6. And the frame rate also stayed around 63, 62 frames. So you say, okay, if the graphic performance reduced by 1/3, why is the frame rate the same? The answer is because this one here uses OpenGL, but it's CPU limited. But what do we do now with the GPU performance decrease with the Mac Pro? I tested the legacy patcher, the latest version with OpenCore. I increased the spoofing level. I used an older version of the legacy patcher with an older version of OpenCore. I tried Martin Low's Mac Pro package, and you find all links down in the video description. Martin Low made packages specifically for Mac Pro that focus on graphic acceleration. I used these packages all around 90,000 points in Monterey. And then I took my productive SSD, where I cut my videos, and did a benchmark with 12.5, 90,000 points. Upgraded to 12.6, no change, 90,000 points. And then I had an idea in my mind. If Big Sur is running with 130,000 points, I took the Big Sur SSD and updated directly to 12.6, 130,000 points. And I didn't find many information, but the explanation might be that in Big Sur, there are certain settings or drivers that when you update will be kept. And this settings, drivers or whatever enables Monterey to run with the full graphic speed. If you do a clean install, it just uses the Monterey settings, drivers, and they only deliver 90,000 points. So that is my question to you guys. Do you experience a slower Mac on Monterey? Maybe you have a second hard disk, or you just want to try it out because there's no important data on your Mac. You install Big Sur, do the benchmark. You can download everything for free. Links are down in the video description as trial versions. And then you do the update to 12.6 and see if you're losing performance as well. Give me your results down in the comments. And I will also dig deeper into the performance loss in the MacBook Air. And maybe I find another solution instead of installing Big Sur and then Monterey, that you can directly bring Monterey to the same performance level. So if you haven't yet, I would recommend you subscribe to the channel and click the bell for notifications so you don't miss a new video where I maybe have find a solution. There's a lot more here on my channel to explore. See you soon. Bye bye.